On the second part of this problem, we will be calculating common ratios to assess how well the company is performing. There are four different types, or what we call building blocks of analyses. There are some ratios that evaluate liquidity and efficiency, some that evaluate solvency, profitability, and some that are geared towards market prospects. The four liquidity ratios that you're going to be calculating are the current ratio, the asset test ratio, the inventory ratio, and the accounts receivable turnover. These four ratios help evaluate whether the company has short-term liquidity issues or not. That means, do they have the financial wherewithal to meet their current obligations as they come due? In addition, you'll be calculating two profitability measures. These were covered in Accounting 100. The first one's called the gross profit margin, and the second one is called the net profit percentage or the net profit margin. I've included some slides to refresh your memory before we start the Excel. The current ratio is calculated as the current assets divided by the current liabilities. This ratio measures the short-term debt paying ability of the company. A higher current ratio suggests a strong liquidity position. Banks like to see current ratios averaging 2 to 1, which means for every dollar in current debt, they have $2 in current assets with which to pay it off. Your classified balance sheet already has the categories of current assets and current liabilities, so these ratios should not be hard to calculate. The second liquidity ratio is called the quick or asset test ratio. As you'll notice, the denominator is the same as before, current liabilities, but the numerator is the three most liquid assets that a company has, which is cash, short-term investments, and current accounts receivable. A couple of profitability ratios are also thrown in here. One is the gross profit margin, which is computed as the gross profit divided by net sales. Again, both of these amounts will be found on your income statement, so this ratio should be readily calculated. And this one will tell you how much a company earns in gross profit from each sales dollar. Similar to this, but based on net profit, is the net profit percentage. And this is calculated by taking net income divided by net sales. And this ratio describes a company's ability to earn net income as opposed to gross profit from each sales dollar. And then there's two turnovers. One is the accounts receivable turnover. This is a measure also of short-term liquidity, and it's computed by taking net sales on the top divided by average accounts receivable net on the bottom. That means after the allowance is taken out. And this ratio measures how many times in a year a company converts its receivables into cash. So if a company has credit terms of 30 days, you would expect them to turn their accounts receivable over about 12 times a year because they should be collecting it once a month. For purposes of this problem, assume that accounts receivable is very similar, and so there is really no need to calculate the average. Just use this year's receivables. Similarly, inventory turnover is another liquidity ratio. And it's computed by taking cost of goods sold divided by the average inventory. And once again, for purposes of this problem, assume that the inventory was similar or the same each year, so there's no need to average the bottom. This ratio measures the number of times that merchandise is sold and replaced during the year. So now let's get to the Excel. Back to our Excel file, which was partially done in the last video, we're going to create a new tab, give it an appropriate name, and give it a proper heading. Again, you're going to do the who, what, when, like you would do on any financial report. So I will go ahead and call this Everything's Roses. This is a ratio analysis, and this is for the year ended 6/30/17. Let me make this bigger so you can see it better using the zoom slider. I'll go ahead and center this at the end. For now, I just want to give you an idea of how I expect the ratios to look. So I expect you to show me the formula. For example, the current ratio is current assets divided by current liabilities. So I expect you to show that. And then I would expect you to go gather the data from the balance sheet. So to demonstrate that, since I don't have the balance sheet done, I'm going to show you one more. I'm going to show you the gross profit margin. And these should be in the same order that I gave them to you on the handout. So let me move this one down a bit. And up at the top, let me show you how to calculate the gross profit percentage. So again, you're going to show me the formula, which is the gross profit divided by the net sales. And then I would expect you to show me the numbers that you used. So let me go grab my gross profit and put my equal sign in here. My gross profit can be found on my financial statements. Here it is. We calculated it earlier. So I'm going to cell reference by clicking on it. And my net sales, I'm going to press the equal sign, go click the financial tab, and grab my net sales. And I'm going to clean this up by making the numbers user-friendly, which means I'll let you decide, but I'm going to use probably the comma format with no decimals since I don't have any decimals. And then I'm going to show my answer in the appropriate matter, which if it's a gross profit percentage, then I expect to see the number, the answer as a percentage. So let me calculate this on my computer and calculate this as a percentage, maybe with a decimal place, and that would be my answer. And then you can write down here whether you believe that to be a good or bad percentage. You need to comment on the results of the ratios. So if you believe that's a good ratio, you would write that down and why. And again, I expect this to look nice and neat, which means, for example, that this will be centered. You guys know how to do all of this by now. I'll let you decide what looks nicest. Maybe some shading. Maybe at least a border. But that's what I expect the ratio analysis to look like. Show me what you're calculating, how you calculate it, what the result is, and assess the result. So that should be enough to get you started. By the way, of course, you have to show me the formulas. I've had a few people email me asking how to do that. The best way is to create a new tab, and I'm not sure what the directions tell you to call it, but for demonstration purposes, I'm just going to put formulas for ratios. Okay, and then go back to your data, hit the select all button here, copy, go to your new page, and paste. And then here's all the information that we copied. Then using the control tilde button, it turns it into formulas. And this is what I want to see. If any of the data in your financial statements change, this ratio analysis will be automatically updated. This is what we call being flexible in our use of cell references. So you have some other things to do on this problem, but that should be enough to get you started. As always, complete the problem according to the directions. Make sure you double-check the requirements prior to uploading your file. Make sure that your work prints out properly. Each worksheet should probably print out on one page. Because your income statement's so long, I would encourage you to use the page break preview to print out the financial statements properly. Maybe the income statement on one page, maybe the statement of owner's equity and balance sheet on another. I'll leave that up to you. I don't expect the financials to fit out on one page, to print out on one page, but I do expect that you would break them in appropriate places. And then, as always, check to see if there's a discussion post that applies to the problem. If you need help, you know where to get it. And again, I'm here for one reason, and that's to help you. All you have to do is ask.